fam! Kamusta naman kayo? Nakakapag-recharge pa kayo last weekend? Ako, super, super duper recharged na and ready to take on this new week! Let's go! Ay, diba? Ang taas ng energy ko. But for this week, we will focus on power and we want to use this power to spread love and good vibes buong linggo. Dito lang yan, of course, on The Place to Be. Be happy, be you. B-R-G-Y. Oh, B-Fam! Naniniwala ba kayo sa your greatest power is to show love, to receive love, and to be love? Bongga! Of course, I'd like to thank Oprah Winfrey for that quotable quote of the day. But for sure, B-Fam, ang stories ng ating global Pinoys prepared for this episode can attest to this. August na, pero let love still fill the air dahil wala naman pinipiling oras ang pag-ibig. Alam mo, August, malapit din yung kasal ng ate ko, di ba? My sister's getting married this August, kaya hello world, hello world! Oh my gosh, guys, alam mo, B-Fam, I am the only person in my family that is not married. Pero matagal pa yun. So let's look back at stories of our lovable G-Pinoys who used love as their superpower to overcome struggles and hardships. To start, let me take you to the land down under where the love story of our G-Pinoy and her afam started in summer and ended in forever. Balikan natin ang sweet story nila Daphne and Marcus and how their love became even more powerful than their differences. Of course, here is our first best of saucy. If we're going back, you know, going back to, you know, where I said you guys had your first day and everything, I heard that it almost took Daphne 2 days. No, it took her 2 days to finally decide to answer when you asked if you could be her boyfriend. I mean, if it's okay to ask, Daphne, why did it take you 2 days?
Like, he made a huge effort just to see me there, see my family, especially my daughter. And which is, it's really a big thing for me. Like, finally, I met a person like who accept me for being who am I. Like, like, I have a daughter, I'm a single mother, because nowadays, like, it's hard to find, like, a responsible partner and who is genuine, like, really, like, loyal to you, like, want to have a relationship with you.
But I'm very, very curious, you guys are in Australia right now, what's your most memorable summer so far there in Australia? I mean, what do you guys do in the summer there? I'm so sorry, I'm so clueless, but I'm so curious.
Nah, look. Over here, it is about the weather and the beaches and sort of outdoor activities. That's what you do over here because it is quite a tropical country. We're Gold Coast in Brisbane. It's always very warm. So we've got the theme parks over here. You've probably heard of the theme parks, Movie World and Sea World. So they're the main attractions, and then you've got obviously, like I said, the beaches. It's an adventurous type of country. So always outdoors with the kids and the family.
I want to go lastly and just ask how the proposal happened. I mean, you guys are married now, and I want to know more about how this happened. Did he propose in a special way?
Yeah, back then I didn't expect that he proposed to me, and then what? And then he just asked me like, babe, can we have like a short holiday, at least just for two nights somewhere in Byron Bay? And Byron Bay is amazing. It's beautiful. Like, oh, okay, babe, definitely. Because I just need a break. And then he even asked my daughter. I have no idea that he asked my daughter, like, I'm going to propose to your mom. Is it okay? Like, can you help me out? Like, you know, record some videos if I propose to your mom, but don't say anything to your mom. It's our secret. Just keep it between us. I was like, okay, Daddy Mark, I'm looking forward to that. I'm very excited. And then when we went there, and then we stay in a hotel resort, which is opposite to the beach. And then it's a beautiful weather. It's just amazing, right?
Yeah, it's perfect.
Yeah, it's perfect. Yeah, and then he asked me, babe, for Tomorrow, shall we go somewhere in a seafood restaurant? But you need to dress up because I will take you to a fancy restaurant. Like, what? Like, what? Why fancy restaurant? Like, you didn't need to do that. Like, yeah, you gotta dress up. And then I gotta dress up to all of us, okay? All right, okay then. Okay, because I know you love seafood. All right, okay, right though. Thank you, babe. And then he told me, like, I was already ready, getting, like, dressed up. And then he asked me, like, can we walk at the beach? Like, I am already wearing heels. Like, so why are you taking me here? I'm wearing heels. I'm wearing dress. Like,
you know nothing about women.
Are you taking me here? Like, no. I just want to walk because it's a beautiful weather. Like, you know, like, just because the restaurant is just, like, at the back of this, like, what is it? It's like a small hill, right? You told me.
It was nearly on the beach. It's pretty much on the beach, the restaurant.
Yeah, it's pretty much on the beach. Like, I was like, oh, okay then. But there's footpath. Why are we're not using the footpath? I just want to walk at the beach. Just enjoy. Yeah? Enjoy the moment. Ah, all right then. Okay, we just keep walking. And then all of a sudden, I was facing towards, to the opposite way. And then he just grabbed my hand. And then he just kneeled down, and then he proposed to me, and I was literally shocked. Like, I was like, what?
Oh my god!
This is for real. I felt overwhelmed. Like, wow, I can't believe that I'm getting married. Am I?
Oh, I can imagine. You know what? Just because of you guys, I'm gonna make my future boyfriend watch this episode of BRGY so he knows exactly what to do. Grabe naman si Daphne and Marcus. Talagang sana all. I loved hearing their journey and their story of how their love bloomed. And mas gusto ko rin yung Australian accent from the Down Under. Wow! Pero talaga naman, love conquers all. Marcus powered through to get Daphne's hand in marriage. This is the kind of summer love trope that we should experience. Yung hindi lang during summer, kundi whole year nagstay. Okay, so before I get too emotional, before masyadong malungkot ako, wow, maybe it's time to get our next story in a little while. Kaya huwag kayong aalis, BRGY will be right back.
Ano ba ang pinagkaiba at pagkakapareho ng tunay na pagkatao ni Seth Fidelin kumpara sa karakter ni Nico Sinan? Pinagkaiba, si Nico is a scholar, si Seth Fidelin ay hindi. Saktuhan lang, medj lang. Ang pagkakapareho nila, pareha silang mapagmahal sa pamilya. Yun mga kapamilya. Kakaibang Nico Sinag po ang makikilala at makikita nyo sa G-Kapamilya Presents Dirty Linen sa Amerika ngayong August 26 po yan sa Memorial Auditorium sa Sacramento, California. Makita-kita po tayo doon mga kapamilya.
Hey, my boy.